Many of you are asking about pre-implantation genetic screening, PGS, and also about freeze all or fresh embryo transfers. Well, we do both of them, all right? So PGS is screening of embryos. And this requires a blastocyst embryo where we take a day 5, 6, or 7 embryo. This is the outer layer, the trophectoderm, and this is the actual fetal area. We take a biopsy between day 5, 6, or 7 and identify the genetic chromosomal makeup of that embryo, identifying if the chromosomes are normal. Now, in general, we're not asking the question whether or not there's a genetic disorder like cystic fibrosis or MS. Cystic fibrosis, because MS is not a known genetic disorder. This is PGD diagnosis of individual genetic disorders, and the S is screening, just a general. One of the problems is this isn't 100% accurate. So there's something called mosaicism, and it may be incorrect. The actual fetus may be actually normal, where the placental components of the blastocyst may be abnormal. So we have to be very careful. I don't think it's for everyone. I think many embryos should be transferred without it. There's some evidence that there's a higher degree of misreading as women reach their late 30s and 40s. So I particularly don't push for it. I think if you have a lot of embryos, then screening the embryos to identify those 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 that are normal, increasing those early transfers to be successful, it's worth it. The other is there's a cleavage stage embryo, which is a day 3 embryo, which typically has 4, 6, or 8 cell embryos, which is how we used to do these biopsies, where we take one single cell, but we don't do those any longer. It's really just at the blastocyst stage. You can also identify gender by biopsying these embryos. But again, our primary rationale for not doing it is because there possibly is a corrective mechanism that may correct some of these cells in utero, and or there may be some errors on the testing. But again, it's something that we can discuss individually. I basically believe that if you make an embryo, put it inside, give it an opportunity to become a baby. Next is fresh. In order to do the blastocyst PGS testing, we need to test it and freeze the embryo. So it's gonna be a cryopreservation cycle either way. Fresh versus cryo frozen cycles. We used to think fresh was best. We would stimulate the ovaries, retrieve the eggs, make the embryos, and get them in as soon as possible. Now we're allowing them to grow longer and freeze them. And the biggest benefit of freezing is that the endometrial receptivity, or the lining of the uterus, may be adversely affected by the stimulation. And quite often, by the time a woman has an egg retrieval or a trigger shot, the day of trigger, the progesterone is often greater than 1.5 to 2. And if it's greater, it may abnormally stimulate the uterine lining, or set it to a stage that it doesn't make it as receptive as when the progesterone is less than 1.5. Generally, if there's a high estrogen level or a high progesterone level, we recommend a freeze-all. If there have been previous failed cycles, we certainly recommend a freeze-all as another different way of doing the process to improve the chances, because I've always said if you keep doing what you've been doing and expect better, often it's the definition of insanity, as we know. So always mixing it up. But if fresh isn't working, go to frozen. If frozen isn't working, go to fresh. If no matter what you're doing here, you don't know whether or not you have a normal embryo, that might be the next way. And quite often I'm recommending the immune protocols for everyone because basically unknown cause of infertility is inflammatory. It's inflammation within your body. That's the males and the females that create abnormal sperm, abnormal eggs, and an abnormal environment for implantation. So we'll talk more about that the next time. But basically, fresh is our go-to. Frozen is now becoming our go-to. If it's a natural cycle, minimal stimulation, fresh works nicely. But if it's a high stimulation, then frozen is the way to go. Open to all questions. Thanks for tuning in. Send them our way. Dr. Rob Kiltz, CMI Fertility Centers.